welcome to Trependous Travels. I'm Laura.
Hi, I'm Ben. This is our VW Crofter, the big orange beast.
Bob, otherwise known as. We got this van about 6 months ago, and we decided to get it converted because we wanted something bespoke and like wooden inside. So we got in touch with a guy called Neville at Off-Grid Campers, and he converted it, and we'll show you around. Have on it.
Welcome to the cab and seating area. In the seating area here, Neville's put us in a removable table made out of reclaimed pine. We've got our two Janny seats, which are also removable.
Here's our pet mosquito. So here's the kitchen area. We got a really deep copper sink from Syncology, which we love. That could also be a baby bath, maybe. And then these Moroccan tiles from Tile Giant. And then Neville put in the window frame. He made some just extra shelving, which is really useful. And we've got all these, oh my god! flying bottles of olive oil in there. Lots of storage. Like funky Germanic aprons. These amazing drawers. Rain's blowing in the curtain. It feels like on the oven we've got three gas burners and LPG, and then you can, the oven's actually pretty big. You can cook all sorts in there. And then we've got an 80 litre fridge and a little freezer compartment. It's the perfect size for four beers, we figured out.
Now I'll tell you about the technical part of the van.
For example, we have a sensor which monitors how much LPG we've got left in the underslung LPG tank.
We have a carbon monoxide detector.
We've got a 240 hookup, so when we're at a campsite, but we've also got an inverter, so we can use the battery and a 240 volt appliance if we're off grid. Water tank and wastewater tank, and this just tells you how much is in either one. We've got lots of different USB sockets throughout the van. There's one in the front, one in the middle, and one in the sleeping area. In the underslung water tank, we have an element for the winter time, and this just makes sure that the water doesn't freeze if it goes below 0 degrees. This panel is to do with heating the water. We can either use the LPG, or if we've got a hookup, we can use the 230 volts to heat it up. We already know. Are you waiting? Are you waiting? Are you waiting? Oh, oh, oh. So this here shows all the different fuses that we have. Easy to replace if you know how. We also have our water pump, which must be turned off when you travel, and our lights, which shuts off all the power to the lights and the other electronics in the vehicle. And this here monitors the batteries, which are understored underneath the bed, and they're being charged from the solar panel, which is on the roof. It's nothing to deny. I. This is the solar panel, the LCD screen. And as long as the face is happy, then we're happy. So we had a Propex heater installed for the winter time. And basically, if you turn it up to the flame, you can hear it kicking in now. The LPG tank is being used for the Propex heater, and it's being brought out using the charge from the solar panel and the batteries. But it's far too hot for that today.
Okay, so this is the extractor fan. You can have it either blowing air in if you're a bit hot, or it can suck out the air. So if you're like cooking something smelly, it's quite cool. In the dark sea.
So I'll give you a tour of my favourite place in the van. Here's the toilet area. Okay, so we've got a compost loo with a glittery mermaid style inner. Then we have some extra storage here, which has all your essentials. So soap bars, salt deodorant, suntan lotion.
So in the compost toilet there is a fan at the back, so it's meant to take out the smells, but we haven't actually done it in there yet. So we don't know what it's going to be like. But I have got this quite fantastic natural antibacterial spray, and it's made out of lemons and some other stuff. But that's really good for keeping it smelling nice, and obviously it's good for the environment. Do you want to come upstairs? Yes, this is the bedroom. It's, how long's the bed? I can't remember.
1.80 meters?
Yeah. So Neville, the guy who converted it, he's put these like frames in to make it bigger on the each end. So you can fit your feet in that end and your head in this end, which is good. Got lots of cupboards here, and this is a little slide out table so you can watch TV in bed. Oh yeah, touch lights, that's quite cool, and a little hatch. And then it's, this is my favourite bit, so it's got the mosquito net or the blackout. Designed this bed area based on our, we had a teardrop caravan, and it was just amazing. We loved how cozy it was and how we had cupboards at the end and the table that pulled out. So we asked Neville if he could do that, and he did very well. I'm gonna see it when my spirit's on the run.
Now it feels of 100. Now to show you the under the bed area. So this is the under storage underneath the main bed. Under here we have two leisure batteries, we have an inverter, there is the Propex heater and the water heater, they're all behind here, but also we have all this storage. It might not look like it, but there's a lot under there. Under the bed itself, that's the three drawers that we have. So one for me, one for Laura, and one for the baby.
So this is the electric pickup point. We haven't really used it that much because the solar panel's been so amazing. This is the water fill-up bit. And we've got our taps under here, so fresh water, wastewater, and that's LPG. And then over here, there's a coolest bit. We have our outdoor shower connection, as Ben will demonstrate.
So we have the hot water and the cold water. You obviously have to heat up.
Don't actually know how to use.
Hang on, let me just try it first.
Pretty cool.
And the LPG tank heats up the water, and then we can have hot and cold showers. Perfect for washing your feet after a day at the beach.
Or a baby's bum, you know, in time to come. So yeah, we just basically decided that we wanted a mini retirement, because we don't want to wait till we're 70 odd. So we're going to live in this van off-grid for a year minimum.
So we've decided to go as eco as possible, so we have reclaimed pine, we have a compost loo, and on the roof we've got a solar panel which is going to provide all our electricity.
We hope you enjoyed our van tour.
If you'd like to follow more of our Trupendous Travels, then hit the subscribe button and check us out on Instagram and Facebook using the links on the screen. Fade into the end, someday fade.